Welcome everyone. I'm here with contact lens specialist and owner of Ezekiel Eyes, Damon Ezekiel. Welcome, Damon.
Thank you. Thank you for the invite.
That's great. In this video, we're covering what are hard contact lenses and to give you more of a picture of more of an understanding of what they are. So Damon, what are hard contact lenses?
Thanks, Lee. So, you know, in the contact lens world, there's soft lenses, which I think the majority of the world know about. And then there's rigid lenses. And I prefer to talk about hard lenses and call them rigid lenses, because hard lenses, patients get a sense that this is something that's, you know, not as comfortable. So, you know, we prefer to deal with talk about a rigid contact lens. So a rigid lens is a rigid material. It doesn't flex. And we need a rigid contact lens for certain patients because of the shape of their eye. It really gets down to the shape on the front of their eye. And if it's distorted or irregular, that is exactly what the patient needs. There's many different types of rigid contact lenses. There's different materials. The majority of the materials we use, we've really narrowed it down to one or two because they're nice and stable and they're a high breathing material. Most of my contact lens complications I get is with soft lenses. So rigid lenses are easy to clean, keep clean. They breathe more than the softies, so they're just so much healthier. They do take a little bit longer to get used to than a soft lens. But most of my rigid contact lens patients love them and their vision is sensational. So the quality of their vision cannot compare to what you get with a soft lens. Okay, so, and when a patient comes in, we will talk to them about what you need. And if it is a rigid lens, we'll talk to them about the different options. We start at the basics and then, you know, the different options from there.
What is it about rigids that's easier to keep them clean?
Because it's a rigid lens, it's literally firm, you can actually put a little bit more pressure on and clean them and rub them. Whereas soft lenses, it's a lot harder to get a physical rub onto them with any, you know, punch to it.
Yeah.
Being, you know, a soft lens is so much more porous, it'll absorb more bacteria, protein, calcium from your tears and things like that. Whereas a rigid lens, even though it breathes, it's a lot harder to get a build up on the lens. It does happen, but if you can keep it clean, and you know, it's just it is an easier lens to keep clean for longer.
That's great. And what's the typical lifespan for a rigid lens?
So the majority of our patients, we would get 2 years out of their contact lens. Okay, right. So if you look after them well, you'll get that 2 years.
Great.
Okay, and we recommend 2 years because as you get closer to 2 years, well, as lenses get older, through wear and tear, they will warp and change shape. So they're no longer a size 10 shoe. They've now morphed out to an 11 and a half.
Right.
And the pores in the lens will block up, so they will breathe less. Okay,
right.
So we do like to replace every couple of years.
For sure. What do rigid lenses look like? Say a corneal lens.
If we look at a soft lens has a diameter of, say, 14.3 millimetres. A rigid lens is anything from, say, 8.6 millimetres up to, you know, 11 millimetres. So a soft lens will cover across the coloured part of our eye onto the white, whereas a rigid lens is just going to sit within the coloured part. So it's a lot smaller. And all contact lenses, when a patient blinks, the lens should move. And we have this tear pump that pumps tears out and pulls new ones underneath. So, you know, we need to make sure that the lenses move. But it is definitely smaller, and we fit them a lot differently to soft lenses.
And just like a shoe, we want it to move a little bit, but not too much.
That's right, yeah. So, you know, you can go the extremes where it's moving too much, or the other side where it's too tight. And a tight lens feels fantastic because it doesn't move. But over time, it'll cut down the amount of oxygen to the eye and we'll get more blood vessels and it's going to cause a lot of complications. So there's that fine line between a lens that's moving too much, not enough, to just perfect.
Sure. What are rigid contact lenses used for?
So the majority of rigid contact lenses are fitted for patients with a distortion on the front of their eye or very high prescriptions. But a lot of it gets down to that curve on the front of the eye. So when a patient comes in, one of the things we do is to measure we take a topography map on the front of the eye. So it shows me the whole curve and shows any valleys and peaks and troughs. So then we can work out, right, well, there's an irregularity down the bottom or off to the side. And that's where, if you've got an irregular shape to the eye, what we want to do is put a new front to the eye. And that's where a rigid lens works beautifully. Whereas a soft lens is just going to wrap on. So that distortion is still there. So unfortunately, you know, patients, and we see a lot of patients with distorted corneas, the front of their eyes distorted, a soft lens and glasses, it just can't get them to the vision that they need. So a rigid lens will just, you know, improve the quality of their life amazingly.
For sure. And even if I don't have a distorted cornea, if I did have some astigmatism, it's likely that a rigid lens would give me sharper vision.
Yes and no. So same again, when we measure your curvature on your cornea, it depends where that astigmatism is. Is it on the front of the eye, on the cornea at the front, or is it within the eye? So it does depend. But the important thing is, you know, I see a lot of patients come in and say, oh, I've been elsewhere, I have an astigmatism, and I've been told I can't wear contact lenses. Depending on what that astigmatism is and where it is on the eye, within the eye, 99% of patients with an astigmatism can wear contact lenses.
That's amazing to be able to be told that finally they can.
And if you're driven and you want contact lenses, then we can certainly look after you.
That's really good. Are rigid contact lenses better for dry eyes?
Dry eyes is a tough gig. There are certain conditions where we do fit patients with rigid lenses in the dry eye world. And we're not talking the little corneal lenses. What we tend to do is we use what's called a mini scleral. And a mini scleral is a lens that's anywhere from, say, 14 millimetres up to, say, 18 millimetres. So it's big and it sits on the white of the eye. The beautiful thing about these lenses is that they sit on the white and they vault up over the coloured. So the white of the eye, the insensitive, and there's this beautiful big tear layer between the back of the lens and the front of the eye. So there's this beautiful wet bed. Then we keep the front of the contact lens nice and wet and moist. And for certain dry eye patients, you know, it is fantastic. There's a lot of things we would try and do beforehand, but, you know, it's certainly an option. But that's one of the things we do at Ezekiel Eyes, is try and really customise what you need. And let's try this. Okay, that didn't work. Well, let's try this. We have a very big armoury of goodies to play with, whether it's for dry eyes or soft contact lenses or rigid contact lenses.
Absolutely. And you've got the drive, the experience to be able to know what's the best suitable lens for each person.
Absolutely. And, you know, Lee, we have patients who come in who are wearing the little rigid lenses, and, you know, it might just be 12 months old and they need a little bit of a polish. So in our practice, we're very spoiled. We have a little polishing system at the back of the house. We'll take the lenses off the patient, go down the back while the patient's in the chair. We can polish the lenses, adjust the edge, increase the edge so it's not, you know, so it's more comfortable, or give them a little bit of a polish. You know, 5-10 minutes later, they're cleaned up, back into the patient, no downtime for the patient. So in that aspect, it's fantastic that we can do in-house adjustments, no downtime for patients. So we're very spoiled, but that's what we do for our patients. We want to go that little extra step.
Yeah, that's great. You go the extra mile to keep people happy.
Absolutely. And do as much as we like to do as much as we can in-house.
Absolutely. So how easy are rigid lenses to put in?
Okay, so Lee, when we first see our patient and we've diagnosed and we've done our trial fitting, the patient will come back a week or so later, and then we'll fit the lenses, check that they can see, that the fit of the lens is looking okay, and everything looking as it should be. We'll then teach the patient how to get them in and out and clean them and look after them. Now, in our practice, we will not let a patient take a lens home unless they're comfortable and they're confident that they can get them in and out. And that's fine. Some patients will come back 3 or 4 times. But, you know, from my point of view, if a patient takes the lenses home and they can't get them in and out, they're going to sit in the top drawer and that's it. Nothing's going to happen. So it's really important that we sit down and make sure they're comfortable. And you need to be comfortable. So sitting down over a white towel, and we teach them the in and the out and how to center them, all the pitfalls, run through the solutions, all written down in a booklet, so that when they leave, it's all there. We give them a wearing schedule So it's a couple of hours today, tomorrow, and build up that schedule. And like I said, if they're not comfortable, great. Leave me the lenses, come back a couple of days later, and we'll just keep going through it. It's like anything new, you know, letting your tire tie, your shoelaces. You've got to get comfortable with touching your eyes and touching these little bits of, you know, breathing plastic. So once they know and they're shown, it is easy, but it's a learning curve. You know, the first week, you know, might take a little bit of time, but by the time I see them for a review in a week or 10 days, most of my patients are very happy, the in and the out. But, you know, at our review consultation, we always talk about how is the in and the out and solutions, and we try and explore all those little holes where they're just not sure. And some patients do come back a second time and say, look, just can't get this one in or one out, or, and, you know, we sit down and just run through it again. So as long as the patient's comfortable and confident, then I'll let them take them home.
Yeah, because it matters to you that you know how they're doing, how well they're doing with their lenses.
Yeah. You know, otherwise they're not going to wear them, and it's, I've failed, and, you know, I haven't got the patient to where they need to be. And there's different techniques to get them in and get them out, and that really depends from patient to patient. So that's a, you know, part of what we do is tailor make for you what you need. If one type of removal technique is not working for you, well, great, let's try a different option. And there's a couple of, there's probably about three different ways you can get rigid lenses out. It's just a matter of, let's start with what I think's the easiest, which works for 80%. And if you, if it doesn't work for you because of the anatomy of your eyelids and eye, then fine, let's try something else.
It's at the end of the day, you will be able to practice and you'll get a technique that works best for you.
But the important thing is that you know that you're confident that when you leave my room, you'll be able to do it at home by yourself.
So I've got a rigid lens in my eye. Can it get lost behind the eye?
Well, that's a great question. So one of the things we do with it when we're teaching patients how to get lenses in and out at their second visit is that there's a centering technique. So if the lens, which should be sitting on the coloured, slides down, up, down, left, right, how do we get it back on? So remembering with a rigid lens, because it's got this curve to fit on the coloured, if it slides onto the white, it's going to stay there. It's not going to come back. So the white of our eye makes an envelope with the inside of our lid. So if you look right up, it's about there. It's not that far. And right down, it's there. So we teach patients a centering technique. So if the lens is up, we get them to look down. And we just with a little bit of pressure, pull the lens down, holding it through your top lid, look up towards where your finger is, which is holding the lens on the inside through the lid, and it'll just slide back on. So it's very simple, in the corner, up, down, and same again. The majority of the time, obviously, if you can put the lens straight on the coloured, straight off the coloured, then you don't have to, you know, chase it around your eye. But it's not going to get lost and, oh, here it is. it can only go up and down so far.
That's good. Could you tell me, if I'm interested in looking at rigid contact lenses, what sort of ballpark am I looking at for the cost?
So there's a huge variety of lenses. So off the top of my head, I think the rigid ones start at $395 each. And then depending on whether you're having two curves on the back and two curves on the front, the cost increases. If you've got keratoconus or you've had post-surgery, that changes. And then we go to mini sclerals, and they're over $1,000 each. And then we go to a bigger scleral, which is a mini scleral is up to 18 millimeters in diameter. We then also fit these, rarely, but we do fit these scleral lenses, which are actually fenestrated, so they've actually got three holes in them. And they're up to 24 millimeters, so they're big, they sit right in. And they're over at $2,000 each. So they're all, there's, it really depends what do you need. We always try and start at the most basic, and if we can get you a great result, comfort and vision, and you're happy, you can wear it all day, great. If not, then we'll look at tailor making something and upgrading you to something.
Thanks for talking to us about it.
Thanks, Lee. Thanks for your time. I really appreciate it.
That's great. Well, if you'd like to make an appointment with Damon, what's the best way to make an appointment?
So, Lee, the best thing to do is ring 9386 3620. You can go to our website. My colleague and myself are ready whenever you are, or at the bottom of this video, there'll be some links.
Fantastic. Fantastic.
All right, thank you.
That's great. If you like this video, please click like and also share it with a friend as well. Thanks very much for watching.